All right, ladies and gentlemen, here they are, the World Tag Team Champions, the mighty Road Warriors, Hawk and Animal.
David Crockett, I'd like to just say one thing. We'd like to say to everybody out there, thanks for all the hate mail you've been sending us. It's quite an inspiration to us. Matter of fact, it inspires us to hurt, maim, and disrupt lives more than we already have. Now let's give some credit due where credit's due. Lex Luger and Sting, we never underestimated you as physical specimens. We just underestimated what you had between your ears to back it up. So we found out that you're not any stronger or bigger than we thought. You're just a little bit smarter than we thought. Our mistake. But when we make mistakes, we always compromise by doing something about it. And what we're gonna do about it is in Greensboro tonight, we're gonna rip some stinking face. And it ain't gonna be ours. It's gonna be yours. And there's one thing that will always remain different between the two of you and the two of us. We simply don't care. You know, the other night in the ring, I heard Animal hit Sting, and he made a sound like it hurts. Well, you ain't heard any sounds come out of us like that. Because if it did hurt, and sometimes it does, we ain't gonna let you know about it. The other thing different between you and us is we got these and you don't. Tell them, Animal.
No damn Crockett. I heard I got a match December 7th against Dusty Rhodes, right?
That's correct.
Dusty Rhodes, you seem to forget. We ain't doing this sport just like you had. Your credentials speak for themselves. You got a long history of wins against great opponents. But we made a name for ourselves by beating legends. Legends just like you. So you're going to find out what I'm all made of December 7th, and you ain't going to like it one bit.
Oh. All right, Paul. He's just walking away without saying a word. Paul Ellery, the World Tag Team Champions. They leave us. We don't know what, you know, you heard Animal talk about the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. That match is going to take place December 7th. Talk about the American Dream. Here he comes. Hey, Dusty, he was out here to talk about it.
Let me tell you something about this old Texas boy right here. You've been coming out here week in and week out talking trash. Let's don't wait till Chattanooga, Tennessee, Daddy. Let's don't wait till December the 7th. If you want some of the Dream, the legend, if you will, in public, come on out and get it right now.
All right, Dusty wants him. Dusty said, Animal, if you want him, get in the ring. Here comes Animal. Why'd you want him so bad? You want him, go get him.
All right, it's gonna break down right here. They're not gonna wait till December the 7th in Chattanooga. Big Road Warrior Animal, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is like a street fight here. He misses with a clothesline. Rhodes to the far side, catches Animal with a clothesline, and he's trying to choke. Well, that's 2-on-1, Tony.
Well, you knew it would happen, Jim Ross. You knew good and well with all the Road Warriors here that it would be more. And all of a sudden, we see Animal. He has taken off one of the spikes. He has taken off a spike, and he has hit Dusty in the head with it.
He just hit Rhodes right in the face.
Oh, my goodness.
God, he's put it in his eye. He's put the spike in his eye.
He is jabbing him in the eye, or has with the spike. He unhooked it from his shoulder pads or whatever it was, and he's jabbing in Dusty's eye. He's opened Dusty up.
Oh, my God. They're trying to put his eye out.
This is horrible. They're
sticking that spike right in his eye. The Road Warriors, they are trying to blind him. They stuck that spike right in his eye. Rhodes is bleeding. But you can hear him screaming, Tony.
He is in a tremendous amount of pain. And you know, Jim Ross, the first thing I thought of when I saw this was that maybe this great career has come to an end. We got to get out of this. We'll be right back.
Well, they've come back out. You know, Jim, you brought up a good point about these two men just a minute ago.
I followed their career since they got in the wrestling profession. They put a lot of guys in the hospital, but never with a foreign object, gentlemen. I think we're a little
Jim Ross,
one step beyond.
What you want to do right now is hand that mic in our face and shut your stinking mouth before I put your eye out with my stinking fingers. Hey, Animal, what you got all over your hands?
I
I got the dream's blood.
Ain't that the American dream come true? We didn't even feel like wiping it off or clean off. We just want to live in the gloriousness of it. You know, some people call their dog Spike. Football players spike the football. And people spike drinks. But some people, namely us, spike dreams. And that's what we're all about.
Well, I think we need to take a look at the situation one more time. It's a horrible situation, but let's take a look. It happened earlier on this program.
Talk about the American dream. Here he comes. Hey, Dusty, he was out here to talk about it.
Let me tell you something about this old Texas boy right here. You've been coming out here week in and week out talking trash. Let's don't wait till Chattanooga, Tennessee, Daddy. Let's don't wait till December the 7th. If you want some of the dream, the legend, if you will, in public, come on out and get it right now.
All right, Dusty wants him. Dusty said, Animal, if you want him, get in the ring. Here comes Animal. Why do you want him so bad? You want him, go get him. All right, it's going to break down right here. They're not going to wait till December the 7th in Chattanooga. Big Road Warrior Animal, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is like a street fight here. He misses with a clothesline. Rhodes to the far side, catches Animal with a clothesline, and he's trying to choke. Well, it's 2-on-1, Tony.
Well, you knew it would happen, Jim Ross. You knew good and well with all the Road Warriors here that it wouldn't be more. And all of a sudden, we see Animal. He is taking off one of the spikes. He has taken off a spike, and he has hit Dusty in the head with it.
He just hit Rhodes right in the face.
Oh, my goodness.
God, he's put it in his eye. He's put the spike in his eye.
He is jabbing him in the eye, or has, with the spike. He unhooked it from his shoulder pads or whatever it was, and he's jabbing in Dusty's eye. He's opened Dusty up.
Oh, my God. They're trying to put his eye out.
This is horrible.
They're sticking that spike right in his eye. The Road Warriors. They are trying to blind him. They stuck that spike right in his eye. Rhodes is bleeding. But you can hear him screaming, Tony.
He is in a tremendous amount of pain. And, you know, Jim Ross, the first thing I thought of when I saw this was that maybe this great career has come to an end.
You know, Jim Ross, if anybody's got any doubt if this is real or it's not, take a look. That ain't plastic. Dusty Rhodes, your first mistake was even making a challenge to me. Now, maybe you had a chance with both your eyes, but you don't stand no chance at all with one eye. Don't you ever call yourself a legend. Come out here and take advantage of that, because I ain't going to back down from no man. December 7th, I am going to finish the job. You may have no eyes at all. Dusty Rhodes, I think it's time for you, like you said before, lay this body down, and maybe your time. We're going to find out December 7th.
You know, we come from the streets, and on the streets, you do anything to win. Dusty Rhodes, I got a new name for you, Popeye. Popeye Rhodes.
Well, I'm sure you have something to add to this. You're happy, I'm supposed.
What we saw was Darwinism at its finest. Survival of the fittest. And Dusty Rhodes, what goes around comes around. Now we're going to have a charity for you, Dusty Rhodes. A charity for your eye. And all your fans can send the money to the Legion of Doom, and I'll make sure you get it.
Tony, I don't know what we can add to that.
Well, like we said, Dusty has been taken to the hospital. We don't know the seriousness of the injury. David has gone with him, an official of the NWA, and hopefully next week we'll be able to report on the situation on Dusty Rhodes.
We certainly will. And fans, we'll be back with more exciting action right after this.